This amendment would make the actual substance more constitutional. As is, under the Pennsylvania Constitution, it is not legal to demand to make requirements either of local governments or the Department of State through resolution. The way to do that is through an actual bill. So my amendment would correct that constitutional issue right now. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This amendment would keep this task, this responsibility of auditing within state government. I think that's exactly where it belongs, because recently we have seen issues with private sector vendors messing up in key parts of the electoral system, the voting system here in Pennsylvania. Most famously, most notoriously, in Allegheny County, there were thousands of vote-by-mail ballots sent to the wrong district. And that really produced a big problem for the people running the elections in Allegheny County. By adopting this amendment, we would keep it in-house, in state government, and that would allow for better quality control. This amendment, yet again, deals directly with the lack of constitutionality in relation to the underlying resolution. What this resolution is trying to accomplish must only be done through a bill. Doing it as a resolution is absolutely unconstitutional, and this specific amendment would eliminate the hard deadlines for the County Board of Elections and instead encourage submission by the counties, thus making it constitutional. It is no surprise or no shock to anyone that the biggest stronghold for the Democratic Party in Pennsylvania is the city of Philadelphia. In the city of Philadelphia, Joe Biden won 81% to 18% in this past election. That's why it is absolutely a fascinating fact and quite perhaps mysterious, and let's hope there was nothing sinister going on, the fact that the mail service in the metropolitan Philadelphia area in the week lead up to the November 3rd election was the slowest in the entire country. I think if we were serious about a true review of the election, I think that this issue should be forefront to it. In relation to the point from the honorable member from Bedford, I would point out in regards to the constitutionality of my amendment, it is constitutional because this is not requiring the federal government to do anything. It is asking for a review. Thus, it is completely in line with the separation of powers in the United States Constitution. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in support of the amendment from the member from Philadelphia. I specifically rise because of the inappropriate language in relation to the Supreme Court and also the Department of State. The Supreme Court, unfortunately, has become a whipping boy recently for the GOP, and that is rather unfair because they have followed the law appropriately. Even the Supreme Court followed the law in relation to the naked ballot decision. The naked ballot decision was strongly opposed both politically and through legal ways by Democrats. And then in relation to the Department of State, it is very unfair that they're being criticized here, because ultimately their interpretations of Act 77, they were really just trying to do the best job possible with the language that came out of this body last October, which was unsatisfactory in relation to what the true meaning was. So I would support the member from Philadelphia's amendment because it rectifies rather unfair criticism. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In response to the member from Jefferson County, I am not arguing that there was not confusion on Election Day. I'm arguing that the origin of the confusion actually stems from Act 77 and the unclear language that it passed this body in last October. I don't believe, ultimately, it is the fault of the Department of State. I move that H.R. 1100 violates Article 2, Section 1, Article 3, Section 1, Article 4, Section 15 of the Constitution of Pennsylvania. Mr. Speaker, on page 2, lines 13 to 16, the resolution directs the Legislative Budget and Finance Committee to coordinate and manage a risk-limiting audit of the 2020 general election. It does not request that they do it, it directs it. On page 6, lines 24 to 30, the resolution orders the Department of State, an executive branch agency, to assist the LBFC in its audit. Separation of powers be damned. On page 7, lines 4 through 9, county board of elections or registration commissions are ordered to comply with the LBFC's request for data. Mr. Speaker, Article 2, Section 1 of the Pennsylvania Constitution provides that the legislative power of this Commonwealth shall be vested in the General Assembly. It does not vest that power in the House of Representatives. It vests it in the General Assembly. Nonetheless, here we are with a House resolution, a resolution that will not be presented to the Senate for its concurrence, attempting to hijack the legislative power of the Commonwealth from the General Assembly, blatantly cutting the Senate out and claiming the power as our own. Furthermore, Mr. Speaker, Article 3, Section 1 of the Pennsylvania Constitution provides that no law shall be passed except by bill. But here we are trying to order the executive branch and local governments to do something, an act of law, via a simple House resolution. Finally, Mr. Speaker, Article 4, Section 15 provides that every bill which shall have passed both houses shall be presented to the governor for his signature. But again, here we are trying to pass an act of law via a simple House resolution. Not only are we cutting out the Senate, but we're also cutting out the governor. Mr. Speaker, what's next? If we're going to be enacting laws these days by resolution, will we be just disbanding the Pennsylvania Senate and the Office of Governor soon? We apparently don't think they have any role in our lawmaking process anyways. Mr. Speaker, for the reasons stated, I urge my colleagues to join me in declaring that H.R. 1100 is unconstitutional. To me, it's impossible to consider this resolution without context. The context is Donald Trump and his supporters alleging mass fraud in Pennsylvania and the United States. Despite there being no evidence of systematic fraud, it has not stopped Donald Trump from tweeting just today that there was mass voter fraud in the city of Detroit and that 20,000 people were still on the voter rolls and possibly voting illegally here in Pennsylvania. The issue of the 20,000 people in Pennsylvania who were deceased and still in the voter rolls, Donald Trump left out the fact that these were individuals who had died very recently. Thus, there was no time to get them off the voter rolls. The evidence, the most compelling evidence that this was a free and fair election is, frankly, the results that I, as a Democrat, don't like. In January, when we sit here, the Republican Party will have 3 extra seats. The Republican Party also had historic wins for Auditor General and Treasurer. So I ask anyone, how was there systematic voter fraud that prevented Donald Trump from winning Pennsylvania if we lost 3 seats in the State House and had historic losses? We as Democrats had historic losses for Auditor General and Treasurer. So let's not delegitimize democracy, and let's vote no on this resolution. The member from Lebanon County makes a key point, and he makes probably the most important point that you can make today. This resolution must not in any way delay certification of the presidential election by December 8th. If it did, I would view it as a complete attack on democracy here in Pennsylvania. In terms of context, as we consider this resolution, we must be cognizant of the fact that there is a movement of Trump supporters who want that to happen. There have been protests around the country. There have been prominent media personalities who have advocated for this. There have been U.S. senators who have been quite noncommittal in relation to the prospect of state legislatures controlled by the GOP in states won by Biden doing an override. We must oppose that. And again, I appreciate the words of the representative from Lebanon County who said that this resolution is absolutely not about delaying certification of Joe Biden's victory by December 8th. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.